हेलो फ्रेंड्स, धनविनियर टॉपिक इज ब्रेंकियल अपैरेटस। सी, इन द ब्रेंकियल अपैरेटस फ्रॉम आउटसाइड टू इनसाइड इट इज अ क्लेफ्ट आर्च एंड पाउच। ओके, सो द निमोनिक इज कैप। ओके, क्लेफ्ट आर्च एंड पाउच फ्रॉम आउटसाइड टू इनसाइड। क्लेफ्ट इज डिराइव फ्रॉम एक्टोडम, आर्च इज डिराइव फ्रॉम मीसोडम एंड पाउच इज डिराइव फ्रॉम द एंडोडम। विल डिस्कस इंडिविजुअली क्लेफ्ट आर्च एंड पाउच। ओके, विल स्टार्ट ऑफ विद द क्लेफ्ट। Now cleft, first cleft gives rise to external artery meatus, external artery meatus. Okay, second to fourth cleft. Now what happens to second to fourth cleft is initially it forms something called as temporary cervical sinus, and later on this cervical sinus gets obliterated. It gets obliterated. Okay, so the first cleft gives rise to external artery meatus. Second to fourth cleft, initially it forms cervical sinus and after that it gets obliterated. Okay, now one clinical importance of a cleft is, see, I told you second to fourth cleft gives rise to temporary cervical sinus which later on gets obliterated. For example, suppose if doesn't get obliterated, then it forms a condition called as a branchial cyst. Okay, it forms a branchial cyst. Okay, now see, this branchial cyst is surgical importance. You have to remember three points about branchial cyst. The first point is it is located in the lateral wall of the neck. The second point is it is located in the anterior border of sternocleidomastoid. And the third point is it is immobile during swallowing. It is immobile during swallowing. Next, let's discuss pharyngeal arches. There's a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 pharyngeal arches. Okay, see, the fifth arch disappears. Fifth arch disappears. See, this 5 is written as Roman number 5. Okay, see, 5. Okay, vanish. Okay, you can remember like that. So, fifth arch vanishes. You don't have to remember anything about this fifth arch. Okay, next, the nerves of these arches. First, see, it's remember again by odd numbers 5, 7, 9. After there are two tens. Okay, two tens, and the branches of it is SR, supralangulum, and recurralangulum. Okay, so it is 5, 7, 9, and there are two tens. Okay, next, the vessels of these arches. See, the first arch, the magic letter is M. The second arch, the magic letter is S. M stands for maxillary artery, S stands for stapedial artery. Third arch, it is C. C for carotid. How to remember? See, C is the third alphabet, right? See, A for 1, B for 2, C is for 3. So you can remember like that. Third arch is carotid. Fourth arch is aorta. How to remember? See, F O U R. Fourth arch. Okay. See, there is R here. There is R in aorta. Okay. Okay. See, fourth arch is aorta. Fifth arch, you don't have to remember anything. It is a vanishing one. Okay. Now, sixth arch is pulmonary artery. How to remember? See, six. If you write it in an inverted way, see, six is P. So sixth arch is pulmonary artery. So it's all very easy to remember. Only thing, you have to open your eyes and see them carefully. Okay. Next are the derivatives of these arches. See, first arch, magic letter is M. So most of structures starting with letter M, like maxilla, mandible, malleus. Okay. Second arch, magic letter is S. So most of the structures starting with letter S, like stapes, stapedius, styloid process, styloid, ligament, and muscle. Okay. Other than that, see, anterior bill of digastric is derived from the first arch, and posterior bill of digastric is derived from the second arch. Okay, plus from the first arch you will have also tensor muscles coming up. Okay, so your totally these are tensor muscles are tensor tympani and tensor velae palatine. Totally this entire first arch derivatives you can remember one more by the mnemonic as M A N T, that is MAT. Okay, MAT. M for the magic letter, A for anterior bill of digastric, and T for the tensor muscles. And a third arch, see, it is stylopharyngeus. See, three. 3 is a very stylish number. It has got a lot of curves, and hence see, stylopharyngeus, very stylish. Okay, so third arch is stylopharyngeus. Fourth and sixth arch, you can simply remember like for most of structures of the pharynx from the fourth arch, and most of structures of larynx from the sixth arch. Other than these, there are some miscellaneous structures you need to know. Okay, first is the cartilages. One is your Meckel's cartilage, and second one is your Richter's cartilage. One is Meckel's and one more is Richter's cartilage. Meckel's cartilage is a magic letter M, so it's derived from the first arch. Okay, your Richter's cartilage is derived from the second arch. That was first thing about cartilage. Second thing is about the hyoid bone. See here, this is the greater horn of the hyoid bone. This is the greater horn of the hyoid bone. Okay, and this is the lesser horn of the hyoid bone. Okay, look at this green line. Structures above this green line are derived from the second arch. Structures below this green line are derived from the third arch. So the lesser horn of the hyoid bone and upper part of the body of the hyoid bone is derived from the second arch. The greater horn of the hyoid bone and the lower part of the body of the hyoid bone is derived from the third arch. Okay, and the third miscellaneous structure is tongue. See here, you have to remember one thing, in tongue T is not there, okay? In tongue, there is no role for second arch. See, this is anterior 2/3 of the tongue, this is the posterior 1/3 of the tongue, and this is the root of the tongue, this is the root of the tongue, okay? See, first anterior 2/3 of the tongue is derived from the first arch, okay? The posterior 1/3, there is no 2 here, so it is derived from the third arch, and the root of the tongue is derived from the fourth arch. So it is 1, 3 and 4, there is no role of 2 in the tongue, okay? Great. Now after that, see, those are the three miscellaneous structures we have discussed. The first thing was about cartilages, okay? One was Meckel's cartilage, one more is Richard's cartilage. Meckel's cartilage from first arch, Richard's cartilage from second arch. Second miscellaneous structures we discussed was about hyoid bone, okay? The lesser horn of the hyoid bone and upper part of the body of hyoid bone is derived from the second arch. The greater horn of the hyoid bone and lower part of the body of the hyoid bone is derived from the third arch. After that, tongue, okay? The anterior 2/3 tongue is derived from the first arch, the posterior 1/3 is derived from the third arch, and the root of tongue is derived from the fourth arch. Okay, now last thing is about any one clinical importance of pharyngeal arches and abnormalities in the first layer. Pharyngeal arch gives rise to a syndrome called as a Pierre-Robin syndrome. It's a pediatric syndrome. Okay, Pierre-Robin syndrome. The characteristic feature of this syndrome is micrognathia and cleft palate. Let's discuss the pouches. The first pouch gives rise to a middle ear cavity. The second pouch gives rise to tonsil, okay, tonsil. The third pouch is remembered by the word third itself, T-H-I-R-D, okay. So the third pouch gives rise to thymus and inferior parathyroid, okay. If the inferior parathyroid is derived from the third pouch, the superior parathyroid should be derived from the fourth pouch, plus the superior parathyroid also gives rise to parafollicular C cells of thyroid and artemobronchial bodies. Okay, next, the clinical importance of the pouches, and the syndrome is Digoge syndrome. Okay, it is Digoge syndrome. It is a 22q11 deletion. Okay, there is an aberrant development of third to fourth pouches. Okay, so there will be no thymus, hence there will be T cell deficiency because there is thymic aplasia. Okay, there will be no parathyroid development, hence there will be hypocalcemia. So T cell deficiency along with hypocalcemia is a characteristic feature of Digoge syndrome. Along with that, this syndrome will also have cardiac abnormalities.